This video covers the installation of an ECM 1.5 kit onto an 1100M and M plus mill. This video doesn't replace the Tormach technical document that came with your machine. Please read all of the warnings, cautions, and tool requirements before you begin. Power off the machine by pushing in the emergency stop button on the operator's box. From the Path Pilot interface, select exit. Turn the main disconnect switch to off. In the electrical cabinet, remove the wire trough covers. Use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove the four screws securing the ECM board cover and set these aside. On the ECM board, mark the top white connector to help with the reinstallation, then disconnect each. Disconnect all other cables. Remove the four brass standoffs and remove the board. Remove the ECM 1.5 board from the electrostatic bag and then use this bag for the ECM 1.4 board. To receive a refund payment, you must repackage and return the ECM 1.4 board back to Tormach. Remove the remaining brass standoffs and discard. Install the first four nylon standoffs in the same location as the brass ones. Mount the ECM 1.5 board into the electrical cabinet with the four remaining nylon standoffs. Verify that the logo on the ECM board is upright. There are two jumpers on the middle of the board. Remove the right jumper and move it to the top pin. Make the wire connections on connector J1. From left to right, attach wires 443 through 445 with a small, flat blade screwdriver as follows. Transfer wires 402 through 408 from the old J1 connector into the new connector. When finished, verify the wires are configured correctly. For the ECM 1.5 board cables to correctly fit in the electrical cabinet, you must first remove several tabs by cutting them off with snips. Put all the connectors back onto the ECM board. Verify that the white connector you marked earlier is in the top location. Install the fuse in the bottom left corner of the board. Reinstall the protective cover with the four screws. Make the VFD connections. Turn the latch on the VFD cover with a flat bladed screwdriver. Then slide down and remove the cover and set it aside. Identify wires 403 in the terminal T41 and terminals T1. Please ensure that the pair of 403 wires are going into T1 and the single 403 wire is capped off with a supplied ferrule. Use a small, flat-bladed screwdriver to connect the following wires from connector J1 to the VFD. Replace the VFD cover that you set aside earlier. Place all the wires into the wire troughs, and then replace all the wire trough covers. Close the electrical cabinet door. Verify the installation. Power on the machine, twist out the emergency stop button, and press the reset button. Do a test of the axis movement. Jog the machine in each direction and confirm that they move as expected. Do a test of the spindle movement. Set the RPM to 500 and press forward. Then press stop and repeat for reverse and confirm that it moves as expected.
If you have any troubles or need any assistance, please contact support@tormach.com. If you like what you saw, please go ahead and watch some of our other videos here and subscribe down here.